Flamingo is the end of the road. It's deep in the heart of the Everglades, right at the edge of Florida Bay. This is where fresh water meets salt water, and the two interact. As sea levels rise, this is the front line. That's why we've come here. I wanted to see it for myself. Florida Bay and the southern Everglades have been shaped by forces both large and small. Global ice ages, massive hurricanes, and even the deposits of centuries of microscopic algae have all played a role in creating this place. The result is a spectacular wonderland for fish, wildlife, and people. In the course of my work for Ocean Conservancy, I've explored every corner of Florida's waterways. I've discovered extraordinary places, witnessed amazing wildlife, and learned important insights from my fellow Floridians. What will the future hold for the animals, plants, and people of Florida? Today we are in a crucial moment. Florida's ocean, coasts, and natural places are at a crossroads. The health of the ocean depends on what happens in the Everglades. If the Everglades is sick, the ocean and coastal environments of South Florida will be too. The stories of sea level rise in the coastal Everglades are echoed in Florida's cities. Fresh drinking water wells are becoming salty. Homeowners' septic systems are failing from saltwater intrusion. And in Miami, the streets are now regularly flooded from king tides on days that are perfectly sunny. The consequences of sea level rise could be dire for the Everglades. If sea levels rise just a few feet, vast portions of the Everglades could end up underwater. Even more important than flooding is what happens underground. As sea levels rise, the landward march of saltwater through Florida's porous limestone will taint the very freshwater aquifers that provide drinking water for millions of Floridians. Talk to me a little bit about what you're seeing with respect to rising sea levels and climate change related impacts. So rising water temperatures also and how that's impacting the fishery, but also how sea level is impacting the Everglades.
So this place is fairly unique in the sense that if there's too much salt water, it's called hypersaline. And that hypersalinity scenario causes algal blooms. And it does it here specifically because we don't have tidal influence in the center of the bay. From east of Snake Bite all over to Blackwater Sound, there's no tidal influence. And so that water sits. And when it becomes too salty, that hypersalinity causes this very specific algae to grow. And it creates a green fog. That green fog blocks the sun. It sucks out the oxygen, and then the grass dies. And you know from your fishery that when the grass dies, there's no fish. So we're looking at entire areas of the bay that are dying when we have hypersaline situations. And we're already existing in a hypersaline situation. Because we don't have that freshwater flow from the northern part of the Everglades, the bay is already hypersaline just on an average day. And so if you combine that with no rain or excess sea level rise or a south wind that holds salt water in here, and that creates that petri dish that caused all those problems in 2015.
So what's the highest level of elevation in the Everglades?
Oh my God, I think it's 3 foot.
Yeah, 3 foot, I think it's up at Rock Reef. Or
that's right, yeah. Rock Reef Pass is the highest part of the entire Everglades, and you know, it takes a lot to climb up it. It's all 3 feet.
Yeah.
You know, but from a layman's terms, if you were driving on the street, you really couldn't even tell the difference.
Yeah. South Florida's geology offers little protection against rising sea levels. Throughout the Everglades, vast stretches of land rise only a few feet above sea level, and the porous limestone that lies underfoot can do little to hold back the salt water. The signs of sea level rise are emerging everywhere. Freshwater marshes collapse as saltwater pushes inward. Mangroves march inland. The vegetation and the soils tell an ominous story, and the consequences of sea level rise have only just begun. So sea level rise, climate change, water quality and abundance, freshwater, fisheries, all of these things are interconnected in Florida. And speak to that interconnectedness a little bit.
Every single person in the state of Florida, and every single person that lives in a coastal community in this country, is connected to the water. And so when you have issues like sea level rise, like stormwater drainage, sewage problems, fertilizer problems, global warming that causes issues for the water, all of that is connected to your health and the livelihood that you depend on. I mean, there's no way around it. So the connectivity is greater than just sea level rise or just sewage, stormwater runoff. It's more about our livelihoods and our quality of life and how that water is connected to everyone.
So tell me what you hope the Everglades and Florida Bay looks like in 20 years.
In 20 years, I wanna see this bay healthy again. I wanna see freshwater flow, I wanna see fish, I wanna see an industry that's revolving around swimming. I wanna see communities that are educated and aware of water issues and are sensitive to our effects on them. And if we can get there, then we'll see a healthy state, a state that can combat sea level rise and climate change.
The ocean is changing at a rapid pace, and these changes will not stop at the ocean's edge. They bring new risks to the Everglades, its animals, and its entire food chain. It's also a looming challenge for the millions of people who live here. If we are to secure a future for the Everglades, the salt marshes, and the mangroves, we cannot ignore the changes happening in the ocean. Just as the creeks and tides flow endlessly between them, their fates are intertwined. Hidden in the thick mangrove forests and beneath the water's surface, nature uses creativity almost beyond our imagination. Even when facing impossible conditions, nature finds ways to endure. Humans, like nature, must use our creativity to meet these challenges. These incredible environments are giving us clear warnings about the future, but our fate is not sealed. We have a choice. To secure the future we all want, we must act.